Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous videos we talked a lot of things. Now we are going to talk about the basic HTML components we had, right? Input type select, like we have a select drop down, we have a date picker, we have a radio button, we have a checkbox. Okay, so how should we create these set of component using Formic form tag or Formic field tag? Okay, so to understand this, we need to understand the input types which are available in the HTML forms. Okay, so give me a second. Okay, yeah, here. So there is a list of input types which are provided in the HTML5. You can see input type search, radio, checkbox, text field, password, email. So everything, every type of form component mostly covered with input type. Input type checkbox, okay, checkbox. Input type radio, okay, I have a radio. Input type button, I have a button. Input type text, input type email, input type password, input type submit, input type file. Most of these form components are covered with single input tag. Only the type attribute we are changing. But what about the select? Select is different from the input type, right? So whenever you need a drop down in the HTML form, you have to use select tag, right? So how our form tag or form field tag can render that? Till now we just talked about the input type text or input type email, input type password, input type submit, and this Formic field tag is able to render that. Now what will happen if you want to render the select or drop down, right? So we will write that. So this is the Formic component, and what we are going to render is like initial values. Sorry. So in the initial values, we have few properties. Those properties are like, so this should be an object. So I can have a name, I can have an email, and another field is gender. So maybe we can use gender for the drop down, like male and female. And we have another method is validate. Inside validate we are doing validation of values which we have received. This should be a method, and we are getting values here, and we will do the validation on values. So we can just simply say basic validation we are doing only for email. Okay, other than that we have on submit and then render method. On submit is also a method. So we have created this dot handle submit something outside, okay, and then we have a render method, and from the render we are actually passing the props, render props. Then this is our component we have, and here we will return our form. Okay, so you might have known, like in the Formic component, either you can use render function or you can wrap, you can render the whole form as a children of this Formic tag. Okay, here we are using render function. So in the render function also you can put your the whole form component. Okay, how we are doing it is here we can write our form tag. This is my form tag, and here I can start writing the field. Okay, so with the help of field tag, I can have all the values. Okay, so in the field, I can set type text, and I just need to take care of name property. Name is this name, and I can have another property which is error message. If any validation error is coming, and I just need to provide a name property, that's enough for validation. Similarly, I can create a three set of these. First is for name, second is for email. Input type here will be email, name property will point to email, and this error message will point to email. Now next property which we'll have is a select box, because here we have a gender. So in that case we can't use simple field tag, I mean not same as we are doing for type text and name property. So here let's see input. So field name is gender, Okay, what else? So component, we have to provide another property here, which is a component. And here in the component, we have to provide, this is a select. So for me, field tag will understand, okay, this is a select drop down. Okay, and inside field tag, we have to provide the options. Okay, here you can put a placeholders and all the other attributes. Field component and select options, and you can provide two options like we provide in the HTML form. Same, nothing different. Right, I think I can remove this. So I have this select drop down now. Error message name will be now gender. This will be the same. So what I have changed is basic things. Here I have a props, and from the props I will be accessing few things like in the bottom I have one button, submit form. So using props dot it's submitting, I can check if button form is getting submitted. Just a little bit formatting. Yeah, so now our form is ready. Here for input type select, I mean for the drop down, there is no input type select, sorry. So for the select drop down, we have to use this field tag with the component as a select property. Okay, apart from that, everything will be the same. Here we have options, like you can render these dynamically based on some data you are getting, and whenever you are selecting, this value will populate in the gender property. And here you can also write the validation for the gender property. And we have a handle submit method. So handle submit is nothing but we can simply write it outside render function. Okay, handle submit, we are accessing the values, and set submitting, set submitting will be false once you submit the form. Okay, so important part is this here, because other things we have already talked about, how to do the basic validation, how to write the input text fields, either it is a name, text, password, file and all. Here for select component, name will be select, and it will behave in the same way. It will render the select drop down with these two options, and we are using forming form tag, not a simple HTML form. Okay, so this is quick overview about select. So maybe we can also talk about input type radio and input type checkbox in the coming videos. Thanks everyone. Once we are done with all these components, then we can write a common renderer function in this form. So we can actually pass one JSON. JSON will have a type field, type select or type radio, type text, type password. And based on that, we can render these field tag dynamically. Okay, input type text, radio, password, all these things render field. Input type select, then render this, right?